Welcome to the third and final video in our series about writing the climate. Again, I've included some writing ideas for you at the end. Writers have been addressing the issue of the destruction of the natural world for longer than you might think. For instance, The Machine Stops by E.M Forster is a short story which was first published in 1909 and is an amazingly prescient evocation of what life might be like if humanity lived separately from nature. Set in an unspecified time in the future, it tells the story of Vashti, a lecturer, and her son Kuno. They believe that the atmosphere has become poisonous to human beings, and they live in small pod-like rooms on opposite sides of the planet. A vast network of underground cities has been constructed so that humans are able to live safely as long as they remain separate, communicating via screens rather than meeting face to face or touching each other. Their lives are controlled by the machine, a mysterious entity which provides food, clothing, and shelter. Chillingly prescient lines include, "People never touched one another. The custom had become obsolete owing to the machine." Apart from one paper manual, the Book of the Machine, all information is communicated electronically. The forest, says Forster, had been destroyed during the literature epoch for the purposes of making newspaper pulp. Rebellious Kuno makes trips to the surface which are illegal. Even scholarly research is forbidden there, as direct information is regarded with suspicion and second-hand knowledge is constantly recycled. The divorce from nature has resulted in humanity becoming estranged from reality itself. One lecturer communicating via the screens predicts the coming of a generation which has gone beyond facts. Here, Forster seems to be accurately predicting not only a world dominated by the internet, but the rise of fake news and social media echo chambers. But the machine's capacity is finite. The air is not as fresh as it was, and water is beginning to smell. Forster seems to have predicted both the destruction of the natural world and the current pandemic. It's worth remembering that these two things are intimately connected, as many scientists believe that viruses such as COVID-19 are zoonotic, passing from animals to humans, and that these viruses are emerging with increasing frequency because of the destruction of vast natural habitats, such as rainforests. So this fable resonates strongly in the current situation, in which we communicate with each other remotely and live in fear of human contact. Our estrangement from nature is not as extreme as that of the characters in the story, but we are on that road. Forster is famous for his phrase, "only connect," the theme of his novel, Howard's End. That novel suggests that morality and empathy are dependent on people making connections and seeing where connections lie. Equally, Forster was making a case for a connection between the head and the heart, and suggesting that while making such connections is of paramount importance, the modern world places innumerable obstacles in the way. Life is becoming more and more atomized. People are increasingly estranged from one another. This story has a similar effect, offering a warning about the effects of disconnection and painting a picture that portrays our own situation with chilling accuracy. Readers in the early 20th century might have read it as a far-fetched fantasy, but in the last century we have gone a long way towards finding that this is our inescapable reality. In the pandemic, we were reassured and inspired by nature and celebrated this fact by posting electronic images of the non-human world on the internet. This brought us comfort in our pods. So now, for the last time, it's your turn. Read The Machine Stops. It's only around 12,000 words long, and we'll put a link to it below. Write a short piece imagining yourself in the world inhabited by Vashti and Kuno. Take an imaginary journey across their planet and think about what you would see. Can you import any details from your own life into this environment? Try branching out from the story as it's written, imagining that you are exploring the surface of the planet. another passenger on a plane, or one of the people to whom Vashti is speaking via her screen. That's the end of our videos. I hope you've enjoyed them, and I hope you've enjoyed starting to write about the climate. Do share the activities I've suggested if you have found them useful.